So what causes actual bone loss? How do you get osteoporosis or osteopenia? There's a number of environmental things that damage the bone. Cigarette smoking is a big one. So people who are long-term smokers have a much higher risk of developing loss of the bone. Really, any inflammation, chronic inflammation in the body can do it. So that's over here. If you look at folks who have like Crohn's disease, celiac disease, any of these autoimmune diseases are actually at higher risk of bone loss. Sedentary lifestyles, because you're not really using, you know, your bones. It's like the astronauts I just mentioned. Seems like diets that are low in calcium and D may put people at slightly higher risk, but that's where there's some controversy, because it's not necessarily recommended that everybody in the world take calcium and D supplements, but you do need to have a sort of minimum amount in your diet. It does seem to run in families. And then there's other specific, more specific diseases. There are glands called the parathyroids, which sit on our thyroid gland that regulate calcium and vitamin D in our body. Folks who've used high doses of steroids, this is not just 5 milligrams of prednisone, but people who are on 60 milligrams of prednisone or equivalents get loss of bone. And then probably the most important thing for, especially for this room, is that testosterone or estrogen lowering therapies reduce bone health. Testosterone is good for the bones. And if I don't have my, I usually have a picture of Arnold Schwarzenegger here from 1970 or something when he was like built. And that's because he was taking tons of extra testosterone to get that big, and his bones were thick and strong and healthy. So when we give people Lupron or remove testosterone from the body, we end up doing the opposite. And that's why the bones get weak.